you're in for a scare.
Halloween is finally here once again. My favorite time of the year. And now it's time to celebrate the best way I know how. Horror shorts. Yeah. Once again, Goosebumps style. Yeah. Based on one of my favorite horror anthologies of my early, late childhood years. And it's such a splendid night to enjoy this holiday. Now, to get set up. As usual, no copyright infringement intended. Let the show begin now.
Caleb had initially told the 911 operator that he woke up to find his sister dead in her home. His statement to the police was that the babysitter had sent them to get the party because they were tired from playing outside in the rain. Upon investigation, police found that the doors were locked securely from inside, and there was no sign of struggle or shooting his body. If no one had broken in, it was plausible that the murderer was someone who knew the family and was trusted. Upon questioning, the babysitter explained how she had left after Caleb had managed to get his sister to sleep and was extremely tired of him. He was confident that he could take care of himself and that he wouldn't hold him to look for anyone. She had been dozed with a sedative. Caleb claimed he had given her milk from the box, and perhaps the milk was expired or spoiled. But the toxicology reports indicated Hannah's pills and some of her drugs had been in the milk. Almost all evidence either pointed to the sitter or Hannah, except she had sometimes
to her. Now to celebrate Halloween!
Caleb was quiet throughout the wedding. His mother took it for shock. Losing a young sister suddenly could be traumatizing for him. And the police prosecuted.
Now for the first short about a girl who finds a mirror that seems to do more than let you look at yourself. Special indeed. Let's watch.
Looks like you're coming home with me. Thank you. was worried about you.
Why aren't you answering my calls?
Lauren? Lauren.
Hey, I'm talking to you.
Lauren.
Mom? What are you doing here?
I've been calling and texting you and you haven't responded. What's going on? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Then why have you been ignoring me?
I haven't. I don't know what you're talking about.
Look at me.
So beautiful.
Each week, before I'd see you in class, I'd think, this is it. I'll smile at him, tell him that I love him, and he'll say the same. And this time I won't just see him for an hour, I'll see him forever. But then class would come and I couldn't raise a word to you. The bell would ring and I'd think, fuck. Now I have to wait a whole other week for my life to begin. Years flew by. I'd stare at my phone, thinking about you. Believing deep down that you were doing the same. And I thought of you. Or heard someone with the same name at work. My heart would ache a little. And one day, I saw the back of your head as you left a shop. For a brief moment, you looked around and stared directly at me. But then, you turned away. You just kept walking. You didn't even recognize me. I followed you. Approached the window of your home and I saw. You had a wife, two children, and happiness. It was clear to me that you had never, not once ever thought about me. I was just a fly on the wall during those times we shared the same classrooms. I felt so pathetic. I don't want to just imagine anymore. I want this to be real. If I had one wish, tomorrow I'd wake up and you could touch me, speak to me, love me. I wish this could be real and not just imaginary.
Thank you.
perhaps you choose your partners a little more carefully. Now, for the final short. A young boy who's at home all alone, but he starts having nightmares. Nightmares he can't seem to wake up from. Let's see how will he survive this nightmare.
My parents are actually on a business trip this weekend, so I'm home alone. Yeah. Okay, that sounds good. Oh. Sorry, I'm actually gonna have to go. What is happening to me? It's just a nightmare. That's all it is.
What is happening? What is happening to me?
Like he didn't survive that nightmare. Or better yet, the nightmare came through and got him. That's all for now. I will continue to celebrate Halloween until Halloween itself approaches. More shorts, more horror, more scares to come. But until then, next time.